Hello friends, in this session we are going to discuss about instance and memory real-time tuning, that is your first is a shared pool tuning. So here, first of all, this is your architecture of your Oracle database, that is your SGA component. So library cache, which stores the shared SQL and PLSQL code and object metadata in the areas that are distinguished by the namespace. So here, this is your SGA components, large pool is there, database buffer cache is there, redo log buffer, shared pool. At this moment, we are going to focus on this more. That is the first is your shared pool. So shared pool also has some different components. There is the library cache, dictionary cache, find shared areas and the result cache. Here, the data dictionary cache, which holds the row images from the data dictionary tables and also called as a row cache. So here, this is the dictionary cache. What it holds? It holds the row images from the data dictionary tables, also called as a row cache. This is this information. When you are talking about the library cache, which stores the SQL and the PLSQL codes, means whatever the SQL and PLSQL you are executing, that parsing information is storing under your library cache. The result cache holds the result set and the query fragmentation, so the subsequent query can retrieve the result directly from the cache. Means whatever the query you are executing, that result caches is storing under this result cache. Means, so again and again, if you are executing the same query, so whatever the results are there, that is storing in the under the result caches, you can directly get it from it. Fine. So this is your shared pool area, which has a three components: library cache, dictionary cache, shared area, and the fourth one is a result cache. Next, shared pool is managed by LRU algorithm. So new objects are required the memory allocation, recreatable objects are edged out from the cache, objects are made up of the chunks of memory, a memory allocated is whole chunk, the chunk is a continuous, and the LRU operations are protected by latch or mutex. Fine. So whatever the LRU algorithm you are doing, that is protected by latching and the mutating. So what does it mean? So let's see, latch and mutex. So what does it mean? Latch and mutex perform the same function to protect the resources from corruption when accessed by the multiple processes. See, this is the component of SGA. So here multiple processes are there, fine, which is using the library cache. So here it is one kind of locking mechanism which is protecting from the corruption when accessed by multiple processes. Okay, the latch is an inexpensive form of lock. A single latch generally protects multiple objects in the SGA. Fine. So here, whatever the you have single latch, that is generally protects the multiple object in the your SGA. Mutex is a short form of the mutual exclusion object. A mutex similar to the latch is a low level serialization mechanism used to control access to shared data structure in the SGA. Fine. So this is your latch and the mutex. Here, serialization is required to avoid the object being, because here the serialization is very important thing. Deallocate while the someone is accessing it, read while the someone is modifying it, modify while the someone is modifying it, and modify when someone is reading it. So serialization is required to avoid the object. Means what is the means of serialization? So whenever you are doing the activity, all these things should be required to avoid. Fine, this thing should be avoided. So if someone is accessing it on that time, you can't deallocate it. So how can you do these things? Using latch and mutex. Also, read while someone is modifying it. Fine. So someone is modifying on the time you are reading. So on the time, the serialization is very, very important thing. So to avoid all these things, the serialization is required in the library cache. Next, latches view. So how can you check it out, the latches information? So from the v$latch, you can just check it out. From the v$latch misses, you can also check it out. From v$latch parent, you can also check it out. From the v$latch children, the information you can also get it. From v$latch holders, v$latch name, for all these things you can just get the information about the latches. And also for the mutex, you can see the mutex lib and mutex lib history. So these two are important for the mutex. Fine. So let's see practically how to see these things, latches and mutex, under the library cache using this data dictionary.
So first of all, we are taking the information for the system wide latch statistics, Fine, so here we are using the three data dictionary, v$latches, v$latchesholder, v$latchName. So here we are taking the name, addr, get, miss, slips, immediate gets, immediate miss, and pid. So here all I am just executing this query, and here I am just first of all formatting this name. So here I am just changing the column name, so you will get the better output, readable output. Fine, and the another one, column PID, heading holder PID. Fine, and here you can see this information. Fine, so 535 row selected. You can see this is the latch name. There is the KXDM SGA state launch. ADDR this get 0, miss 0, slip 0, immediate get 0, immediate miss 0s. Fine, so these are the all your information for the latches and ADDRs. Also, you can see we are focusing on the non-zero values. Yeah, so this is the one JSQ state object latch. ADDR this gets this many gets you have, misses 0, slips 0. Fine, so here these are statistics of your gets as latches, and this is the information in the latches. You will find this information for the gets. So there's gets, miss, and slips. So here you can see the PLSQL warning settings. This is the ADDRs, this is the get, this many gets you received, miss 0, slip 0. And other information, immediate gets, immediate miss, they both are 0. So here in this way you can get the information about all your latches in Oracle database using v$latch. Fine, and this is your SQL statement. So v$latch, v$latchholder, and your v$latch name. Fine, now here once you find the latches name and its statistics, next what you can do, latch name, given the latch address, find out the latch name. So here what you can do, you can just give your ADDR to find out the latch name. So here what you can do, let me just find out the first of all ADDR for this PLSQL, and here I am passing this value. Fine, so this is what's your latch name, this is the PLSQL warning setting, this is your latch name. Fine, so this is one, what you can do, you can just find out latch name, v$latch, ADDR, this one, this is the ADDR you have passed, and this is your name of your latch. So in this way, from the statistics, and in case if you have only ADDR, you can just find out the latch name also. Next, display the latch statistics by the name, means here, if you have passed latch name, and if you want to find out the statistics for the specific latch, that you can also find it out. So here what you can do, what is our latch name, PLSQL warning settings. Fine, and here you can just do the searching on this. Fine, so ADDR gets, miss, slips, immediate guess, immediate miss, PID, latch, all this information you can get it from the here. Fine, just you need to pass out the name. So here I am just copying it again, and this information you will get. It's not properly done, so I just need to again, here I need to just do the proper formatting for this. So here I am just doing, this is the latch name I have just passed, PLSQL warning status. Fine, and here I am executing this in a single line. Fine, so here you can see the latch name, this ADDR, this gets, how many gets for this latch, 16346, misses 0, slips 0, and this is the immediate get 0, immediate miss 0, and the holder PID is that is null. Fine, so in this way you can just find it out the information for the latches in Oracle database. So if you want to find out the all the latches, simply just pass out this thing. Fine, so you have, you can see the different three five latches you have in Oracle databases. So from the V$ database, a V$ latches, you can just find out the information for the latches. Also, if you want to find out the information for about the mutex, fine, so how can you find it out? DSC mutex libs. Select star from mutex lib. Fine. So this is the your library cache. This is the location, sleeves, wait time. This is the library cache. Location is this, sleeves, wait time. Cursor pin. Fine. This is the location. This is the 470 and wait time. This is the lib wait time. Fine. So this is the your mutex sleeves you have. Fine, it is giving you the information about the mutex. So in this session, we have discussed about the how to get the latches statistic, how to get the information of the latch by passing the ADDR, how to get the information for the latch statistics by the name, and also we list down the list of latches, and also we have just discussed about the mutex. Thank you.